Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's expert webinar on all about RSA Archer Kickstart to the GRC tool. I am Satyakshi from Spring People. We are India's largest enterprise training provider. I will be your moderator for today's session. In today's webinar, we have our expert, Mr. A. Kumar, with over 12 years of extensive experience in the GRC domain. He has worked across various stages on the RSA Archer EGRC platform, including architecture design, solution customization, delivery, process design, and consulting. He has expertise as a techno-functional consultant with end-to-end implementation of GRC for security operations solutions, top-down risk assessments, business resiliency, enterprise risk management, and compliance management, to name a few. He is also an expert on advanced GRC features like integration, workflow, flows, access control, etc. So, in today's webinar, he will take you through the basics of Archer GRC, including its needs, benefits, along with introduction to the live environment and components. He will demonstrate building an application from scratch and cover access control and record permissions. Finally, he will talk about leveraging GRC for reporting and dashboards, including advanced searches and creating an iView. If you have any questions during the session, please type it in the chat box and they will be addressed by Mr. Kumar after the presentation is over. So without further ado, let's start today's session. Over to you, Kumar.
Thanks, Satyakshi. Thanks, Satyakshi, for the introduction. So welcome all in this webinar. So here in this session, I'll explain you about the RSA Archer. And you all know that RSA Archer is leader in the market in GRC space, right? So you all know that means through RSA Archer, what we can do means we can demonstrate compliance, we can manage risk management, we can conduct audit in an effective way, we can do business activities, business continuity management. So all GRC process we can easily manage with RSA Archer. Right. So before starting means what RSA Archer can do, what are the benefits of RSA Archer, how we can manage the life cycle of the process. I'll let you know about the GRC. The GRC is the backbone of the Archer. And Archer is the GRC tool. Means in market, if you go into the market, everybody will ask me, what is Archer? Archer is the GRC tool. So, and you know that, what is GRC? GRC is governance, risk, and compliance. Right, full form of GRC is governance, risk, and compliance. Governance is, you know that, means setting rules, setting policies, setting guidelines, setting culture in the organization. Right, and risk management is identifying risk which could cause us some harm to our organization, means in terms of brand loss, profit, or some monetary loss. We have to identify those risks prior to happen, and RSA Archer help us to effectively manage those risks. Right, we can easily identify and document those risks in the Archer. After documentation, we can analyze those risks. After analysis, we can further take our step, either we want to accept those risks or mitigate those risks. So we have some inbuilt process in the Archer, like top-down risk management, bottom-up risk management, operation risk management, enterprise risk management. There are multiple modules in the Archer which help us to effectively manage risk management. And third thing is compliance, right? And you know that, what is the compliance? Compliance is adhering rules and policies, guidelines configured by our organization. And organization has to follow that rules also. Whatever the rules and policies configured by the regulatory bodies or government bodies, we have to follow that compliance, right? And in Archer also, we have different modules, use cases like policy and compliance, regulatory management. There are lots of you know, compliance use cases also through which we can easily and effectively manage compliance in the arch, right? We can document our policies, we can document our guidelines, we can document our authoritative resources, standards into the arch, so we can easily manage and map with our policy, and we can come to our decision that we are compliant and or not compliant, right? So RSA Archer is the GRSA tool, and you know, governance, risk, and compliance. We can easily manage all three things, and it is not limited to these three things. In through Archer, we can manage further things like audit management. We have multiple use cases in Archer, like audit management and work papers, all audit policy, which we can manage our audits also, right? Similarly, with the business continuity planning, we have use case like business resiliency, through which we can manage business continuity management also, right? And nowadays in the market, you know, we have other tools also, but Archer is leader in that. Okay, let's go to the next slide. So I explained to you, GRC stands for Governance, Risk, Compliance. The goal of GRC is to help organization effectively put policy and controls in place, how to effectively manage the risk management, keep the right things in right way, right? And we have, through Archer, we have a full visibility of our data in the system. We can, through reports and dashboarding, we can see what is going on. Let's suppose we have some process like incident management. Incident management is a basic process. Here we can use means we can document the incident. After documentation, we can assign the incident to some relevant team. After assignment, we can further investigate it, right? And through reporting and dashboard into the Archer, we can see that what is the current state of the Archer, what are the high incident we got today, it is assigned to the relevant team or not, what are the investigations going on. We can easily do with the RSA Archer. Similarly, with the other process also, if you talk about risk management, what are the top risks we have in the RSA Archer? What are the types of risk we have in the Archer? What is the criticality of the risk we have in the organization? We can easily manage those risks. We can easily demonstrate those risks to our higher management, our stakeholders. So they have clear visibility. What are the high risks which could affect our organization? Right. So I'll show you. I'll show you during we are covering this PPT, the RSA Archer live. So you can see that. Just a minute. This is the front page of the Archer. And you know, Archer is a web-based tool. We can open in any browser. We can open in any browser and we can start working. Yeah, this is the tool here, and in the top line, in the black line, you can see that we have different modules: audit management, issue management, operational risk management, business resiliency, and regulatory and compliance. These are the most important process or modules we have in the organization nowadays. People have to work on that. So in the audit management, we have different use cases like audit engagement and work papers, audit planning and quality, issue management, through which we can easily manage our risk. And in each use case, we have multiple applications. So what is the use case? Use case is the combination of the application, or we can say it's a collection of the application. And every application has its own task. So in the audit engagement, if you can talk about audit engagement and work papers, if you talk about audit engagement, this is the application where we can start our audits, where we can document the details of the audit. What is the name of the audit? What is the type of the audit? Who is the external auditor? What is the scope of the audit? How the roles and responsibilities are distributed? So here we can document everything. After documentation, we can generate our finding reports. What are the gap analysis? How we have conducted the audit, through interview process or through documentation gap analysis. we can identify them, right? So this is the start of the audit. And you know, as we talk about as a developer, right, we need to configure this application from the backend. And here is once you have this training, have the training of the RSA Archer administration 1 or 2, we can learn the process, how we can develop the application, how we can develop the application from scratch. We have lots of good features in the Archer which help us to automate the system for our client, for our customer, so they can effectively use the audit management with less number of clicks. So here you can see that this is the audit management application where we can put that. What is the name of our audit? So engagement name is nothing, is where we can put the name of our audit. Audit plan means before starting an audit, we need to prepare a plan. So in the audit plan, we can provide the details of the plan, right? What is the man hours for the audit we need to take? What, who is the auditor? What is the starting time for the audit? What is the end time of the audit? We can just put our estimation in the audit plan, right? And in the audit engagement application, you can see the, all the details we can put. What is the location of the audit? What is the cost center? Who is the external auditor? Staffing details, scope of the audit, field work, if we need to do the field work, what are the things we need to take care of that? What are the details we can put here? In the wrap up, means when we are closing the audit, what are the details we need to put? How we can generate the findings? So all the things we can put into one audit management solution, and we can generate report after that. After generation of the report, we can send this report to our stakeholders so they can see that what details we have captured in particular audit, and what are the findings, right? And how we can normalize those findings. So with all the details we can get at one place. So we can say that RSA Archer is the centralized repository where we can document the data, automate the data, automate the process, and after automation, we can visualize it easily. Means what happened in our previous audit, what is the current status of the audit. So similarly with the other process also. So here, if we talk about risk management, there are lots of these use cases which help us effectively manage risk management also, like top-down assessment, bottom-up, loss event management, key risk indicator management. So during our training, I'll explain you in detail, means what is the use of each use case, top-down assessment, how we can use that, how it helps organization to effectively implement the risk management process in the organization. Similarly, with the business resiliency, it is for business continuity management. So here also we have different use cases like business impact analysis. How through this use case we can identify the impact if some disaster happened. Incident management is also part of that. Business continuity and IT disaster recovery. Here we can put our details about the business continuity planning and IT disaster recovery. We can put the details over here and we can automate the process. We can conduct different exercises, tabletop exercises with the system itself, right? And regulatory and compliance. This is also very, very important module in terms of organization. So here we can, in the different use cases like policy program management, control assurance, financial controlling, here we can put our details about the policies, compliance, regulatory authorities, financial controls, what are the different controls we have, not only the financial controls, IT controls, or admin controls, all the controls we can document here, and we can map those controls with our policies or with our compliance. We can map those controls, right? So we can understand that we are compliant or not compliant. If we are not compliant, we can further implement the controls to make it into the appetite value of the organization. So this thing we can easily document these data, manage the data, implement the things, and automate the things, right? What I'm showing you, this is the part of front end. Means our customers, our client has to put the data and they can easily manage the process. And we talk about developers. Means if you need to develop the application, here in the toolbox, this is the toolbox, right? You can see Here we have different features we can configure from the back end for our customers. So access control. So they can, from the front end, means users can easily manage the applications. So here we need to configure the users, and we can configure the groups. We can assign users into the groups, groups into the access role. Right, guys? And most important here is application builder. So application builder is the feature where we can develop the application. So here you can see the list. We have solutions, we have application, we have global value list. Most important from where we can start is the solution. So I'll show you the solution. Solution is the list of applications. It is the list of applications. So here in Archer term, we call it solution. And if we talk about the RSA, we call it use cases. It means in both things, use cases and solution are the one and the same thing. Right, use case is also the collection of application, and solution, it is the one on the same thing, so don't confuse in that. And main thing is that solution is nothing, it's the collection of the application. We have different application in that. Now let me give you a glimpse about the solution. Let me open the notepad and explain you something in brief so you can understand it in a better way. So most important thing is the use case or solution. So I explained you, we could have multiple use cases and solution in the system, like audit engagement and work papers or audit planning and quality. These are the use cases, right? And these use cases we need to buy. We need to buy from the RSA, from RSA. And we called it core use cases also. These are the out of the box solutions, we can say. Core or out of the box solution, which you buy from the RSA. Once we buy it from the RSA, we can install in our system. Like here we have already installed. So once we install this audit engagement and work paper, we got all the application under it. Means we can get automatically all the application which is part of this use case. So first important thing is we need to buy these use case and solution from the RSA, and after buying it, we get the application. So further means applications which we got. Well, let me tell you, applications which we got automatically with the use case are called core application. Core application. Because these are the part of use case pre-built application. These are pre-built application which we get, which we got ready made with the use case as per the client requirement. Means we have some client, right? And means after our discussion, after our sessions with the client, we identify that this use case, top down risk management, is the appropriate use case for the client, so that they can manage their risk management process, they can implement their risk management process. So we suggested them that you should buy this use case from the RSA. After buying the use case, we implement it. And if your business is a little bit different than the existing use case, we can further modify it. So if there is no requirement for the modification, then we can implement the same, is out of the box solution. But if there is some modification required, we can still modify this use case. So this use case and the application which is part of this use case are still, you know, we can leverage it. We can leverage it or modify it as per client requirement. Right? And these applications, what we call it core application. Right? And another type of application in the Archer is on-demand application. On-demand applications are those applications which we build from scratch. We don't buy the use case from the RSA. We develop our own application from scratch. After gathering the requirement from the client, we identified that some of the requirements are not as per the use case, as per the pre-built use case. In that case, we can develop our own application. So RSA has given the flexibility that you can develop your own applications from the scratch. So n number of applications we can develop, and we can create our own solution also. So those applications are the on-demand application. Thing is that for on-demand application, we need to buy individual license of each ODA, or ODM is on-demand application, from the RSA. We need to buy individual license, and then we can develop our application, right? And how we can start the development of the application? We can go here you can see that these are the solutions. And if you need to develop our own application, you can go into the application in the left hand side. Yeah, it's loading, 1 minute. Applications. Here you see the list of the applications. So you can see these are the list of the applications we already in the system. Some application are core application. So it means these are part of use cases which we got automatically from the use cases. And some applications are of on-demand application, which we develop ourselves, which we created ourselves. Right, and still means Archer has given us flexibility that we can modify the core application also. If this is pre-built application, but we can modify it. We can change the fields, we can change the sections, and we can do anything with this application. Right. So how we can create the on-demand application? We just need to click plus, and we can start development of the application. And best part of the Archer is it's code-free tool. We don't need to know any coding language. We don't need to learn any coding language for the development of the application. We can develop the application from drag and drop facility provided by the Archer. So here in the type, we can select the application, provide the name of the application. I'm just giving example, new risk register. And here in the solution, it will ask in which solution you want to add this application. Either we can add into the existing solution, or we can create our own solution first from this solution option. And this training will be full hands-on training. You will do the full hands-on, you will do the full practice, right? So you can easily develop the application or solution. So these are the already building solution we have, or use cases we can see. If we want to create our own solution, then we need to go into the solution first, create our solution, then we can select the same solution from this list. Right now, I'm just adding this application in the existing solution. Just select the solution we have. Solution is nothing, it's just a heading. All the working, all the process will be handled by the application. Application is the important thing. Solution is just the heading. So we have added this new risk register application in this audit engagement work papers, and we can create the application from there. So once you created that, this page will open. And here we can design the application. We can start designing the application. So the, here you can see the layout builder. Layout builder is the part where we can create and put our fields or insert our fields here that we can see into the front end. If you remember, means I have opened the audit engagement application from the front end. So whatever the fields you were seeing there, all fields were created in the back end like this. This is the back end part with the developer area where we can develop the application. And if you need to create the fields here, you just need to go here in the data fields. We can see that is here. We have different types of fields, and you know that fields are what are the fields? Fields are the data collection device. We can see where we can put our data. Where we can put our information like risk name, risk type, risk description, right? Or some date fields. Or we can say some numeric fields, right? If we need to put data into the numeric. So here, all these types of fields, we can pick it and we can put it on the layout. So here you can see we have options like text field, numeric field, date fields, attachment fields, where we can attach any document, right? If you have seen some application or some portals in your organization also, if you can relate something, you can see that in your portal also, if you need to configure your profile there, you have some fields. What is your name? What is the employee name? What is the employee address? What is the employee ID? What is the employee resume? Means you can attach as an attachment. So here, similar like that, we can configure a field. Only difference is that we have some automated features we can configure in the system. So we can automate some things after that, after putting our data. And we can easily visualize that data. That's the benefit of the Archer. And Archer, I can see that it's a leader in the market nowadays in the GRC. And there are numerous jobs in the India or outside India in the Archer, in the GRC space. Right? So here we can configure these fields like that. Like I'm taking this text box, and we are here I'm putting like field name, risk name and create field. So once it is saved, we just need to put it over the layout just in dragging and dropping manner. There is no coding required. That's the beauty. Means those people who don't have the coding background can easily learn the Archer, and they can easily implement the solution in their organization. So this field, this name I have created, so like this, we can drag and drop. Right. So similar, we can create multiple fields here and we can put into the application. Just save it before creating any field. We can create more fields. Let me create a risk description. So you can use, you know, whatever you have discussion, you can use your brain, or you can use your meetings, right, to gather the requirements from the client. Means what type of application that they want, what type of fields they want to implement in the system, that you can understand from your client. They will help you. And after getting all the requirement, first step is that gathering the requirement. After gathering the requirement, you can document it. After documentation, you can get sign off from your client. After getting the sign off, you can start implementing the application or start developing the application. Like we are developing right now. So here I'll put risk description. Drag and drop. Right. And let's create some value list type of field where we can add some values in the system so user can select from the front end, or create some text user group like kind of field so we can select some users in the system. So let's create that. So, value list. Generally, value list field we can use So we can provide the list from the backend. From that list, user can select. So if I give you example, like what is the current status? So status, you can select from the list. It is in process, or it is completed, or it is pending, or it is overdue. So this kind of status, if you want to select, see in the record, then we can use these value list option. Risk status. It field. Put it over the layout. And believe me, this training is very, 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 you know, helpful training for those guys who wants to come in GRC domain, GRC space, and learn Archer. It will change their career. So risk status, here we have created this risk status value list, and right hand side we can do some configuration of the field. So right hand side, if you need to add the value for this field, we can add that. So here we can click edit values downwards, and we can provide the values in the back end. So let me configure something, then I'll show this application from the front end, so you will get more clarity after that. Yeah, here you can just need to click add new, provide the value here, like in process, save it, add more values, like complete. Like this, we can add the value, add the list of the values in the backend, save it from here, and close it. And you need to save it for the layout. This is the value list we created. Previously, we created the text box. Let's create more fields. Let's create user group list now. In the user group list, we need to provide the list of the users or groups. A user can select from the front end. So here we have some user field. User group list. For the name, Rick Honor. Put it over the layout. Then the right hand side, just need to do some configuration. We need to add the list. How we can add the list? In the field population option. Just maximize. Click plus. So what are the users or group we have in the system? We can select that. Like this. We can select the users from this list. We can select from the front end, right? And save it. Just minimize from here and save over the layout also. Now we have just created 5 fields. So means let's suppose I'm giving as per the live example in the organization. If you need to create some risk register application, so what type of field we could have? And risk register application, you know, it is the application where we can document that is what we have identified in the system. So in the organization, we could have numerous risks. We can have 100 type of risk, 200. Risk could be anything. Like it is possibility that unauthorized access can enter into your server room. Risk could be some earthquake could happen. Risk could be some fire could break out, right? Risk could be some virus attack could happen. Risk could be HR hasn't selected the right appropriate person without with proper background verification. So risk could be in anything or in any domain. Either it could be HR, it could be admin, it could be operations. Risk could be in anything. So, and the risk management team has the responsibility to identify those risks. So identification, after identification of those risks, we can document those risks in the application here, which we have developed, and we can provide to the risk management team. But suppose that means before this Archer tool or before this GRC tool, right? This GRC tool, what risk management team were doing previously? They have to use some other tools like Excel sheets or Word document to document their data, right? Which was not means, you know, a clear method to document the data, because we could have different Excel sheets. Our data was segregated here and there. It could be in different Excel sheets. So it was difficult to maintain the data. But after Archer, we have single repository where we can document the data. And if, apart from documentation, it helps us to reduce the burden of the risk management team, because we have automated in the backend lots of things, so they don't need to calculate the risk itself. Risk value system will calculate the risk value automatically from them. They don't need to generate the report out of that. System will generate the report automatically and assign to some stakeholders, and we don't need to apply some controls automatically if some risk is above our appetite value, risk appetite value. So directly we can apply the controls from here. Otherwise we need to select the controls, take the controls from the Excel sheet, and we need to prepare some other document. Here we can manage the full life cycle of the process in one system. That's why it means people are going crazy towards the GRC tool or RC Archer, because here we can manage the full life cycle and we have full control of our data. So now let's see these applications from the front end. Let me open new tab to showcase you. So if you remember, I have added this new application in audit engagement and work paper for use cases. This new risk register I have added here. Just click it. Once we clicked it, we can see right now, as it's a new application, we'll not see any record, any data here. But I'll let you know how we can add the data here. If you have 100 risks, we can add the 100 risks here. So presently, this is we call navigation menu. This is the navigation menu. From here, we can navigate into the records. Presently, we don't have any records here. It's a blank application. If you need to create new record, just click new. So these fields we have just created. Then you can see that how easy to create a new application. So this is just, I have given you a glimpse of just creating 4 or 5 fields, right? If you need to create big application, then we can easily create that by dragging and dropping it. We don't need to take other legacy tools like to develop some application in using some coding language. We can easily develop the application without any coding. So here you can provide your details of the risk, like virus attack, right? It happened. So this is the risk we have identified. So here in the risk description, you can provide the details about the virus attack. Virus attack could impact our servers or systems in the organization. Right? So we can provide more details. I'm just giving an example. We can provide more details about the risk description. Here we can assign this risk to some person. Means this risk is this is the risk virus attack, and you are the owner of the risk. Just check that what we can do further on this. So it is assigned to some risk owner from the risk assessment team. Then he can start working further on that risk. Means in the calculation of the risk value, what could be the impact of this risk? What could be the likelihood of that risk? Right? What are the types of controls we can implement? So what are the costs applied for this mitigation of this risk? If cost is beyond our appetite value, that either we can accept those risks or we can mitigate those risks. So this is the risk management term. So what is the duty of risk owner? To determine these things and work on this risk particularly. So we have selected this risk owner, and what is the current status? What is current state of the risk is in process. So we can select from this list, it is in process, and we can save here. So once it is saved, the tracking ID is the field which is automatically configured by the system. A unique ID is generated automatically to the risk. So we can know that means this is the ID of our risk. And further, if we need to come into this risk and see the data, we can easily navigate. That's why these systems are very helpful. So here in select in process, then save it. Right, and close this application. So here one record is created. Similarly, we can create in one application, we can create n number of records. Means if you have 100 disks, we can create 100 disks. And for this year, means we can segregate like this. For this year, we have 100 disks. We can document here, and we can search based on the years also, or we can search based on the number of users also. We can search number of based on the groups it is assigned to. So we can do this filtering, and we can create different reports. We can create data reports. We can create chart based reports like pie chart or donut chart, right, to showcase our data. All options are provided by the system. How you can create the reports? You can go here into the new report. Presently we don't have the data here in this application, but if let's suppose we have data, so we can select the fields which we want to showcase in the report. We can select the fields from here, like risk description or risk name, risk owner, risk status, right? And downwards we can apply the filters. So presently we don't have the field which tells us that there are different filters we can apply. So here we can apply the filter like that. Give us the record only where risk status is equal to in process. Give us that I only want to see the data where risk status is in process. So we can apply that filter like that. Right, and we can search it. Once we search it, we get the data, relevant data. So presently we have only one record where risk status is in process. Right, if you have 100 records, it will give you 100 items here. Right, similarly for other filters, we can apply means give us the status risk where criticality high. So it will give us that data, and we can easily save this report. And we have different notification options. By using this notification option, we can distribute those reports to our stakeholder, our managers, our owners, so that they can see that what are the top risks we have in the system, what are the top incidents we have in the system. So system is doing everything. It is making the life easy of the teams who is using this system. And it is our responsibility as a developer to provide that system to the teams so that they can easily complete their work. And Archer help us in that, right? So I explained to you, Miss, before Archer, people were using different tools like Excel sheet or Word document or PDFs to document their data, but their data was not centralized. Their data was segregated here and there, right? So what we learned from the Archer so far, we learned that Archer is a web-based tool that provides enterprise GRC solutions. Right. Through Archer, we can manage risk, we can demonstrate compliance, we can automate business process, we can easily gain visibility into corporate risk and security control. And we have it provides out-of-the-box solutions. I explained to you that. What are the out-of-the-box solution or core use cases, we can say, what are the on-demand applications, right? And this Archer is built on C#, .NET technology. This Archer platform is built on. We don't need to use this technology to build our applications from that. This system is built on that, right? And through Archer, we can manage the full life cycle of the process. We can comply with the regulations. We can visualize and communicate risk. We can investigate and resolve cyber and physical incidents using different use cases. We can centralize business continuity and disaster recovery planning using a business resiliency module. We can enable risk-based or business-aligned internal audit using audit management solution. So all the things, all the process, we can easily conduct by the RSA Archer system. And it is very easy to develop the application, like I explained to you. And here, this slide telling us that when Archer was not there, before Archer, we were having different tools, right, to document the data, like Excel sheets or Word documents. If you need to conduct some meetings, we have different outlooks we have to use or some meeting tools. But from Archer, we can send the notification to the customer or the user so they can directly come into the system and they can complete their task, right? We can organize meetings from the system also. We have scheduler field through which we can meetings. We can generate help desk tickets. We can generate incidents here. We can document incident here. We can assign those incidents from the system itself. And we don't need to call people by the phone that the incident is generated. You need to work on that, right? No manual process. All the system, all the things are with the system only. We are doing with the system only, right? We can create the reports, we can showcase the different status of our risk, what are the top risks, what are the top incidents, what are the high priority risks, what are the high priority incidents, or what are the top vulnerabilities, we can see. Or if you go, what are the current status of the audit, right? Who is the auditor? We can get all the details from the system. We can do self-service. Here we can see, we can do self-service. Right, after getting access from the system, we can, a user can do self-service. So how easy for us user to work on their process, right? Before that means we were struggling in completing a process, but after Archer, we can easily complete the process. And it is helping us in time consuming, it is making a life balance things, right? So let me give more glimpse about the system, how we can create users and groups, right? So here in the backend, we have access control feature. So the users who are going to use the system, we can create from the user. We can click here and we can create users in the system itself. We just need to provide the user details like first name, last name, user address, user email address to configure the user, right? And how we can, manage the user access control in the Archer. I'll explain you access control. So access control is the feature through which we can manage the access of the application. We can manage the access of the application. You know, we can't give random access to all the application, you know, because here we have our confidential data stored in the application. So we can manage the access, means only the records which are responsible for incident management should be visible to the incident management team. Those records which are responsible, those records which are related to risk management should be visible to only risk management team. No other guys should see those records, right? So how we can manage that access level? We can manage that access level through access control, right? Access level of the application. So first important thing is the user. First we need to create the user profile. User profile is nothing, it's just a small form we need to build into the system. So these are the already users present in the system. If you need to create more users, click add new. Here we can provide the details like user, first name, last name, those are the mandatory fields, and here the username. User 3. Here we can provide address. These are not mandatory, but if you need to provide that address, company, title, you can provide. Time zone where this user belongs to. Language also we can select that. If you need to, you know, if user is from US, we can select the English US language. If he's from the Canada, we can select English Canada or United Kingdom. Or if he's from the Middle East, we can select language as per his country. And system will change the field values as per his language. Field details as per his language names. So here presently, status of the record is, means the user record is active. It's when we create it. But some, if you have entered wrong password 2-3 times, then the user account will be locked and you will not able to log in. So these things we can implement in the security parameters in the left hand side, where we can provide the details, means what could be the password length, what could be the logged out time, what could be the login time, what could be the password complexity, or when the account should be logged if user has logged in 3-4 times wrong password. These things we can provide in the security parameters. And first status is active. If it is logged, then admin has to unlock it. And inactive, it becomes inactive. It means we can specify the times, like means if user is inactive from last 3-4 months, he hasn't used the Archer, then make its login inactive, then it will become inactive. So he will not able to log in further. So active is the thing. We can provide the password for the user here, right? And we can, means once we have added the password, we can provide him the username and login, and he can change his password in his first login if he enabled this option. Generally we have to enable this option, right, for the security concern, so he can change his password. And security parameters we can assign. There could be different security parameters I have explained you. We can assign from here, right? And we can save it. Save the user from this option. And now we can assign this user to a certain group. So in the access control, recommended approach is that first we have created the user. It should be assigned to a group, right? After assigning to a group, it should be assigned to an access role. So access role is nothing which provides access to the application. So in the access role, we can select the application. We can assign the different rights to that particular application. Create rights, read rights, update rights, and delete rights. CRUD, we can say. We can select for a particular application in the access role. Once this is created, we can assign this access role to a group and group users to the group, right? So this could be hierarchy. This is a recommended approach. So we can easily manage the access control. If we assign directly user with the access role, it is difficult for the admins to manage the access control because we can't identify that which user is of which team and he has which application. But from the group, we can identify that this group is of HR. We can provide the name likewise. This is from HR, so he has the this group has the application of HR application, right? Similarly, if the group is from risk management team, risk management group, so we can easily identify that. And going forward, if new user came and he's from the risk management team, and we know that this is the group who provide the access of the risk management application, so we can directly assign that user to the risk management group. So it is easy for us to manage, and it is a recommended approach. So these things are important to provide the access of the application. User we need to create first, then we need to create the group, and we can assign this group to access role. And in the access role, we can select that which application is part of this access role which we are assigning to this group. We can select that, and in the access role we can assign multiple application also, right? So let's suppose in a use case we have 5-6 application we have configured on demand application. We can select that, and once we select that, we have assigned to that particular group. So the whole group has access of those 5-6 applications. So I have created the group here. We can assign the group from this option in the groups lookup. So when I selected here the audit management, let's load it. Let me refresh one time, then it will come. So in the group, we can look up here. We get the list of the group where we want to add this user. So for now, I'm just adding it into the audit management. So whatever the role assigned with this group, audit management will automatically assign to this user. So we can see this role here in the roles tab. So once we assign this group here, this role is automatically assigned to it. And whatever the application we have in this role, right, this user will get the access. This is a user 3. So this is how simple it is. Means we already have the roles. We should know that. Means by the name, we can get it. This role will provide which type of access. So we can assign this user into that group, and role will come automatically. In the backend, when we go into the role, we can see that. Means this group is already assigned with this role. So that's why, means once we select the group, role automatically came. So this way means we can provide access to the user to a certain application. If you want to see the role, or you want to create your own role, you need to go into the access roles here. Here we can create our own access role. So presently we already have these access role in the system. If you want to create your own access role, just click plus. Provide the name of the access role like this, management new, right? In the right, we need to select the application whose access we want to provide in this access role. So here we can search the application we created. For I'm searching risk register application for now. Click apply. Right, click apply, and risk register Anko we just created, or means our application name is different. Let's search that new risk register something which we just created. Yeah, this is the application new risk register we completed, and this is the create, read, update, delete rights, and there are the different options for a particular application. So important option is content record. Content record is that user can create the record of that application. If you provide the rights, the user can read the records, user can update the record. Similarly, with the reports also, he can create the reports, he can read the reports, update the report. Other options also there means he can export the data from the report, he can print the data, he can email the data, he can do some data import. So there are other pages rights also we can provide in the access role, and we can create it. So just save this, this new access role will be created. Only things are left, we need to assign this access role to some group so users can access these applications. So how we can assign this? Just go downwards. We can assign to group from here. We can select the group. So this is the related risk management. So I'm selecting risk management group from here and select it and save. So whatever the users who are part of this risk management group will get access of our new risk register application, because we have assigned this group with this risk management new access role, and in this access role we have selected that application. So by this way we can select the application roles, and we can assign to a group and to the users who are part of this group. So this is as simple as this means. Through this we can control the access level of the application. So those users who are part of admin department, they will get the access of admin application. Those who are part of audit management team, we can provide access only to those audit management application. So this is how we can manage the user group access control. Right guys? Okay. So these are some basic definition we should aware of that. So we'll cover in the training. So user or group or access role, you know that. So value is the simple thing. Value is the information, data we are putting into the field. Field is the data collection device. And record is the collection of different data. Means in the record, what is the record? You know, in one application we can create multiple records, right? I have shown you. Means in the risk register we can create number of risk records. So record is the collection of related field values, and in one record we have different fields, and we can put the data, save it. It become one record. And another is the application. Application is the collection of records. Right? In one application we have 100 records, 200 records. We can have n number of records. So application is the collection of related records. And questionnaire, if you are not aware, questionnaire is like assessment. It is one of the type of application. We will cover when you enroll for the training. What is the questionnaire? Questionnaire is type of the application which is just used for assessments. And in assessment we have some bunch of questions we can configure in the backend, and we can assign to this to some users. They need to answer some questions, and based on their answer we can generate some score, we can identify some results, right? If you have seen in your organization some assessments you got quarterly basis related to your appraisals or related to your manager review, related to information security policy, related to some compliance, you need to answer some certain questions. So similar type of assessments we can generate through the Archer also, right? And solution, again, it's a group of application, right? It's just heading in which we have number of application. It's a collection of the application. And here through Archer, we can log in. I've shown you how we can log into the system. And after login, we can see modules. In each modules, we have these use cases. In use cases, we have number of application. In one application, we can create number of records. Right, in the front end, back end, we can do these activities. And let me explain these activities also. That's important. Access control, we know that means it is used to provide the access to the user. It is used to control the access for a particular user. Advanced workflow is the feature through which we can do some advanced workflows. If we can configure the workflow, we can provide some configure some approval process, so we can directly get the approvals into the system also. Means when Archer was not there, you need to take approvals through Outlook, right? You need to go in person to the manager to get some approval. But here we can generate some link directly to the user, and user can directly came here and they can provide the approvals, right? Application builder, you know that integration is important. We're going to learn in this training, means how we can get the data from the external tool, or how we can transfer data from one instance to another, or one application to another, or through some file transporter, FTP, or if you need to import the data, means let's suppose we have 500 records, we have identified 500 risks, and we need to create the records. So you know that it's very painful to create manually these records. So we can prepare a sheet, Excel sheet. After putting the data into the Excel sheet, we can directly import the data into the system. So 500 records will be created. So these features we are going to learn in this training. What is a data import? What is a data feed? Data publications, management reporting, how to configure the reports, what are the types of reports, database reports, chart reports. We can learn here. And last topic is notification and workspace and dashboard. Notification, how to send the notification to the user, how we can alert the user. So configuration of the notification, we can learn here. What are the types of the notification? Subscription notification, on-demand templates, or report distribution notification. We can going to learn in this training. And it works with a dashboard to showcase our data, is how we can configure the dashboards, iViews into the reports. There are multiple types of iViews we are going to learn here. So this is all this in the toolbox. We have the backend part. In this training, we are going to learn all these features. As a developer administrator, we should have knowledge of these things in the Archer. And these are very simple. Means it's not complicated. We don't need to do any coding. It's very simple. And once I explain it, you can easily get it. Right, and I'll provide the access of the system so you can go into the system, practice it, do your hands-on. Right, that's
sorry to interrupt you, Mr. Kumar. Just an announcement for the participants. Guys, you can post your questions, as we will be moving into Q&A session after 15 minutes, so that Mr. Kumar can answer all your queries. Kindly post your questions. Thank you, Mr. Kumar, for the interruption.
Yes, means we are almost done. So you guys can start posting your questions so we can start answering your questions right now.
So we have one question, Mr. Kumar. He's asking, what is the future scope of RSA? If somebody is doing RSA, then in which fields he can move on?
Yeah, so do that. Archer is the leader in the market nowadays. In the GRC space, Archer is the leader. And with this training, you can easily go into the GRC development and administration space here with the Archer. And you know, here we have different modules also, which we are going, means once you are in this space, we have different use cases like risk management, audit management, business continuity. If you have understanding of this space, risk management, audit management, so you can go into the risk management space going further also. So Archer help you to learn risk management also. It helps you to learn different audits also. Here we have modules of regulatory and compliance. So you're going to learn different standards also, like ISO 27001, NIST, or PCI DSS, right, or SOX, or surveillance or compliance. It means lots of standards you are going to learn during your job work, so you can easily go in any of the domain. But Archer itself is a great domain. It's a big domain, so you can demonstrate your skills in the Archer. You can provide consultation to your clients, means what use cases we have in the Archer, how we can implement those use cases, how it will be helpful for your system. So you can become an Archer consultant also. Archer developer and administrator is the one important thing. After that, you can become GRC consultant. After that, after consultation, you can, means you already started working into the Archer consultation, and now you want to go into some other domain. So if you have throughout knowledge of the use cases, so you can become the solution designer also. solution advisor also. So lots of domain associated with it. It's a vast world. It's a complete sea, right? And Archer is important tool through which you can go into the GRC space easily. Like, I think I have answered your question.
Okay, now the question I have received is difference in two products, RSA Archer Suite and EGRC.
This is not a difference. Archer is a GRC suite. Archer RSA Archer is EGRC suite, right? EGRC is nothing. It's electronics governance risk and control. You are doing all the things over the system, right? Here in the web-based tool. So Archer helps you to manage GRC processes. So both the things are combined. These are not the different things.
Okay. Now somebody has asked that ServiceNow also comes under GRC.
ServiceNow, yes, means, you know, ServiceNow full, I can't, means ServiceNow has lots of other modules also like ITSM, CMDB. But nowadays, means from last 2-3 years, they have entered into GRC space also, ServiceNow. But ServiceNow is not that much matured as Archer is there. Archer has more matured use cases like risk management. In the risk management, they have use cases like top down or bottom up, key risk indicators, loss events. But in ServiceNow, you have just simple use cases like risk management and you are documenting the data. So ServiceNow is not that much mature, but they have introduced GRC also from last 2-3 years.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Kumar. And one more thing, the person is asking, is there any free trial version available for practice? I think he's asking about the labs. So labs, or they have to purchase the version.
During training, I'll provide you the access so you can practice hands-on, because this tool is not free at all. We have to, you know, and Archer doesn't provide to individual. Archer RSA provided to some organization only, right, for the use of this tool. So you will not get it free trial version. You need to take the training and you will get the version from us.
Yeah, so one guy is asking how many hours training program will be. I think I should answer a little bit about it. There are two modules of RSA Archer 6 administration. One is the basic module that is called RSA administration 1, which will approximately goes up to 20 to 24 hours, depending upon the caliber of the participant. It's not restricted to 20 hours. It might take, if the person is fresher, or it might take some less time, maybe some more time. So Mr. Kumar will be able to help you in and out for the training. And for the second, which is the advanced version, that is called RSA Archer 2, that will also take 20 to 24 hours. Now, Ankur, I have one more question for you. Is threat management covered in GRC?
Yes, threat management is part of GRC. So once we get the threats are threats, you know, that means some, you know, unwanted events or which could hamper our organization. So we can get some threats from different sources, different third party tools. So after getting the threats, we can manage the threats here into the system also. We have vulnerability management system here through which we can manage the threats. Or if you want to develop your own applications also, related to your business, you're related to your how you are managing the threats, you can develop in the Archer itself.
Okay. The next question is, what is, like, what we do in LDNP configuration?
LDNP. There is no LDNP configuration.
Let's spell it the short form. So maybe LNDP or LDNP. He's a little confused. So some configuration in RSA.
No, there is no miss. I haven't heard about this BPM configuration. Okay. We have LDAP configuration here. Yeah, LDAP is here.
Okay, I think he has written it's LDAP.
Yeah, it's LDAP. It's lightweight.
LDAP configuration. Yes, he's asking about that. What we used to do in this?
This is used to integrate Active Directory with the Archer, so we can directly get the users and group from the Active Directory into the Archer itself. We don't need to create manually the users into the Archer. We can directly get from the Active Directory. You know that what is the Active Directory? Active Directory is the inbuilt repository of the organization where we store all the user data or the employees data. So from there we can directly get the names and we can insert into the Archer, and further we can assign those names to different application which they want to use. So this is the integration. Yes, we can do that.
Okay, now the next question is, can I know difference between BPM and GRC?
What is BPM? BPM could be lots of things. What is BPM?
Mohammed Sami, please explain your question correctly. Not correctly, actually, with the full forms, so that Mr. Kumar will be able to answer. So that's it for the questions as of now. There are no other questions. So, right. Okay. Now, let's... Mr. Kumar, can we have the slide, please?
Yes.
Thank you so much. So if you guys are more interested towards RSA Archer training, so you can join our trainings, and do check out our super discounted batches of virtual instructor-led trainings on our website springpeople.com. These VIP trainings are leveraged online from the comfort of your home and flexible as per your schedule and location. If you do not find any suitable batches, we would be happy to discuss and schedule private batches for you. If you guys want to join offline training, then do try our online self-paced courses as well. You can find the training link in the chat box for all the RSA Archer training offered by us. For more information, do write to us at training@springpeople.com or call on our number displayed on the current slide. So guys, the upcoming batch is in December 3rd week. You will receive the recording of this session, and you'll get on mail. And rest, Mr. Kumar, you have any inputs from your end? Any last minute discussion you want?
Yeah, means just want to tell you that means you know there is great scope of GRC space in the market, and RSA Archer is leader. There is boom in the job as well. If you go ahead with this training, it will surely pay you back. So don't think further on that. This is a very, very, very good training and good for your career as well.
Okay. And I could any last minute tip for any RSA Archer person why to switch to this technology?
Yeah, but the thing is that, you know, this technology is in great demand and it is easy to learn, right? We don't need any coding skills. We can learn without coding also. Means if you don't have any coding skills, you can easily go here and it will help you and boost your career. Means you will get the job, and once you get the job, you can escalate further in the GRC space. There are lots of domain linked with the Archer GRC. So it is really helpful for those who want to get job in the GRC space, in Archer space. And it is easy to learn, which I mentioned.
Okay, last minute question came from Mohammed Sami, that he has asked that, can I know the difference between BPM and GRC? So he said that the full form of BPM is business process management.
So what is business process management? Business process management is like means how we are processing our business, right? And GRC means both are the same term. GRC is governance system clients, and BPM, what I'm understanding here, business process. So in the GRC also, we are managing the different business processes. So it is one and the same thing. How we are managing it with the different use cases in the Archer. So I explained already, means using audit management or business continuity management and risk management, we are managing it. So it's one and the same thing. We can okay. Term it different things in different tools, but it is one and the same. We are managing the business altogether.
Okay, as we have a lot of questions, but still one last question, let's take it up. A lot of people are asking the prerequisites of the training, like they need any skill before starting this training, or a fresher, or just an architecture can work, can learn this tool.
Yeah, there is no prerequisite. I already mentioned that There is no prerequisite because it's a code-free tool. We don't need to learn any coding language. Means we going to learn everything in the training itself. So guys, don't worry about that. You don't need anything to learn the art.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Kumar, for your valuable insights. I'm sure a lot of people here, maybe fresher, maybe advanced, they will be able to learn a lot of key learnings they have taken from your experience. Thank you very much for coming on our platform. And thank you to our participants. Thank you, everyone. We appreciate you being here. We shall be sending out the webinar recording to all you participants soon. I request you to kindly provide feedback before signing off, which will help us improve the quality of our future events. Thanks again for joining us today. Signing off on behalf of Team Spring People. Hope to see you again for our next tech webinar. Bye-bye.
Thanks, everyone.